Good evening and welcome to the National Arts Club Bonnet Bash at Home. If you're here tonight, I know you love headwear and hats and millinery in general. Tonight's sole purpose is to celebrate all that. My name is Nina Urban of the National Arts Club Fashion Committee, and I will be your host tonight. First of all, I would love to thank the National Arts Club for years of supporting this event, but particularly for giving us a home tonight when we cannot gather in person. The Bonnet Bash has traditionally been happening within the week or two before Easter, hence the Bonnet Bash. Easter bonnets that were Sunday finery worn to parade around Fifth Avenue, for example. It was conceived in 2013 for the first time to celebrate this part of fashion and design. I will tell you more about its history in a little minute. First of all, as I said, I would like to thank the National Arts Club for once again hosting under these more difficult circumstances here. For those of you who are not familiar with the National Arts Club, we are a 501c3 nonprofit based in New York City with the mission to stimulate, foster, and promote public interest in the arts. Annually, the club offers more than 150 free programs to the public, including exhibitions, theatrical and musical performances, lectures, and readings. For more information about the National Arts Club, you can visit us at nationalartsclub.org or find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. If you're interested in becoming a member of the NAC or would like more information, and I hope that will be the case after seeing how awesome it is tonight, please email admissions@thenationalartsclub.org. I would also like to thank the Fashion Committee and in particular its chairs, David Zeiler and Angela Louis, who are amazing at having so many programs, but who have for several years now, taken faith in me to host the Bonnet Bash. And I'm just so happy to share the love for millinery and headgear again with you tonight, albeit in a slightly different venue. As I said, the Bonnet Bash started in 2013 as a celebration of headwear and as our signature social event, a springtime party dedicated to millinery. Usually there is an exhibition of a featured millinery or several, performance, entertainment, hat making for those who come bareheaded and want to participate, but also most importantly, the audience participation. Everybody attending the Bonnet Bash is an artist. Everybody can show off their own creations of headwear, and that has been rewarded with prizes. So tonight also, we will have a millinery hat or hat contest. You will find out the winners later on. As we can't gather in person this year, I do not want to deprive you of the amazing headwear designer who was supposed to be our featured star this year. So we will have a little video introduction of Darrell Thorne.
I'm so passionate about it. I care about it. I love what I'm doing. My energy is going into each thing that I create, whether it's an individual piece or whether it's an event, whether it's a choreographed presentation with 20 other dancers. It's a piece of my voice. I'm interested in bringing joy to a space. I elevate moods. My interest in storytelling and fantasy and iconography and ritual, all these things comes together to create a piece. The piece ends up being kind of a piece of magic, because when you put that on, no matter who, whether it's myself or my other performers, or even when I have guests try on pieces, it transforms people just in the wearing of it.
just wanted to show you this picture. That's me and a guy named Daryl Thorne, who made all of these head dressings and costumes that everybody was wearing there. See his headdress behind me?
In New York, dancer and artist Daryl Thorne is gearing up to perform at the festival. Thorne creates 36 new headpieces and assembles a team of 12 dancers.
Festival employees and contractors like artist Daryl Thorne, who was hired as a performer.
I worked at Beth Israel as a practice manager in head and neck cancer, and they have these thermoplastic masks. They're used for patients with head and neck cancer. I was like, this is incredible as a material for costume.
Tonight is his first solo show, featuring over 70 masks he's created.
What are you up to, Elizabeth Shue?
What happened?
Hey, thank you.
I'm a doctor. Hey, buddy, can you hear me? What's his name?
Baru.
Give me a knife and a straw. Rubbing alcohol, first aid kit, whatever you have back there.
Like this?
A smaller knife.
Now, France, my queen, France!
He looks really good. I mean, whatever he does, he's very artistic.
And we do hope when we can gather again in person, he will take over the National Arts Club with his otherworldly headwear. I think it is time to prepare a toast to all things headgear. I hope you have something in your glass. If not, we will now see what you can put in there. Here's our lovely bartender, our favorite bartender at the National Arts Club, Timmy.
Hello, my name is Timothy Strain. I'm the bartender at the National Arts Club. I'm here, I'm going to make you a lovely cocktail called the Blue Celestial. Sad to say, we're not able to meet in person for the Bonnet Bash. We've been doing it for many years, but I hope you enjoy me making this cocktail. And ingredients for the Blue Celestial. You will need Blue Curacao, Midori, and Mezcal, but you can use also Casamigos tequila instead of Mezcal. Your last ingredient will be pineapple juice. Okay, we are ready. We have our nice cocktail glass. First thing, we're gonna have some. We're gonna use 1 ounce of blue Curacao. This is the main Celestial Mind ingredient for this cocktail. It's gonna be 1 ounce of blue Curacao. Then we're gonna do 1 ounce of Midori, which is gonna go in a shaker. Then you're gonna do 1 ounce of Mezcal, or you can use Casamigos tequila. You know, Mezcal gives a little bit of smokiness, which if you like, gives a nice bite. And then our pineapple juice. That's 2 ounces of pineapple. And you give it a nice little shake. That way you get a good mixture. Now you just want to use a spoon when you strain it. That way you kind of have the blue Curacao to sit on the bottom of the cocktail. That way it gives it that Celestial Mind look. Does it change the taste in the cocktail? Not at all. I just had 3 of these. Don't tell nobody. Nice, that is very nice. And here we go, we have our blue Celestial. To Bonnet Bash.
Here's to you and 2 hats, to everything you can put on your head, to the National Arts Club, and to creativity, until we can be together again. So I talked about the Bonnet Bash. It's not happening in its usual form this year, but we have wonderful memories. If you have ever attended, you will know that it is a great party, and it really brings a lot of artistry. We've collaborated with innumerable wonderful artists over the years. So from Headgear Hereafter with futuristic headgear, when we designed an entire runway for a black light, to the last in-person iteration in 2019, the Carnival of Capital Sins, when the National Arts Club was transformed in a casino environment of indulgence. It's been a wonderful, wonderful experience.
Hey, this is Gordon Kendall. I am member of the Fashion Committee, and I want to welcome everyone to the 2021 Virtual Bonnet Bash with the huge hats off to Nina for putting it all together. Hope you guys have a great time this evening, and I went simple with just my plain baseball cap, Balenciaga, of course, but I'm looking forward to seeing all the exciting hats that are going to come out and see who the award winners are. Looks like it should be a fun evening, and thank you one and all for participating.
Hi, I'm Kate, a member of the Fashion Committee at the National Arts Club, and I'm wearing a hat made by East Village Hats here in New York City for the Neverland Ball circa 2018 at the National Arts Club. It was a great night, and I'm just happy to be here to celebrate hats with all of you.
And I'd love to raise a glass to all of this year's participants, and for the illustrious Fashion Committee, and to our beloved home base, the National Arts Club.
Hello, welcome to Samaraland.
My name is Samara, and this is my studio/home. I'm a performer, a creator, and a headpiece maker.
This year will be my 5th Bonnet Bash at the National Arts Club. It's so special. Every time I go to the National Arts Club, it just makes you feel like you're a part of New York history.
Hi everyone, I'm Deborah Scotti, 6-time participant in the National Arts Club Bonnet Bash competition. My love of hats can be traced back to when I was about 12 years old. My cousin asked me to be a bridesmaid in her wedding, and part of our outfits were these gorgeous wide-brimmed straw hats. When I put that hat on, I felt stylish and confident and sophisticated, and quite frankly, who doesn't want to feel like that every day? I want to thank the National Arts Club for providing such a wonderful space for millinery enthusiasts to come together every year and fill a room with their amazing creative energy.
The Bonnet Bash in real life. But as I said, you will not be deprived of wonderful creations brought by the audience. I would now like to introduce our wonderful hat contest judges. We have here Julia Knox, an English milliner who trained in fashion and as a milliner at the Fashion Institute of Technology in New York. She heads up a small team of milliners at East Village Hats, where she handcrafts hats on the premises using traditional tools, methods, and materials. Julia's hats are a contemporary take on classic vintage silhouettes and often utilize vintage materials. Julia has collaborated with artists such as Pigeon Doll, seen here, and Maor Zabar, and regularly invites international milliners to teach in her hat-making workshops. Julia is also an amazingly supportive collaborator at the Bonnet Bash. She has been one of our featured milliners in the past and has been super enthusiastic throughout the years, and I'm really, really pleased that she agreed once again to be the judge for the competition. Our second judge is the fabulous Verity Hill. Fashion designer Verity Hill was also born in England, in Bristol, and has traveled the world calling places such as Singapore, Belgium, Hong Kong, and Canada home. But for the past two decades, she has resided in the US and half of that with us in New York City, for which we are very grateful. Verity is heavily influenced by the fashions of the 1920s and 1930s, particularly the work of LT. She is specializing in corsetry, however, has done lots of custom work, including wedding gowns, performance wear for stage, musicals, musicians, and film. She is also a wonderful designer for latex and, of course, her amazing headdresses. She has designed for and collaborated with performers such as Cyndi Lauper, and her work has been featured in all notable fashion magazines. Rounding out the list of wonderful judges this year is Sarah Sokol, who has become the milliner to the stars. Sarah's most notable work now is her work with Billy Porter's Grammy 2020 mechanical hat, Janelle Monáe's 2019 Met Gala look, and she has also been featured in Vogue Spain, Vogue Portugal, and others. When Sarah was inspired by the Burning Man Festival originally, when she discovered the variety of creativity in headgear, and then has trained in England. She now lives in Los Angeles, where she owns and operates Sarah Sokol Millinery, and is incredibly productive, working as a theatrical milliner, for example, building hats for Bob Mackie, Linda Cho, and Kathy Zuber, as well as for designers such as Christian Siriano. Now, without further ado, we would love to introduce you to this year's Bonnet Bash Hat Contest. We had 2 months open for submissions, and many wonderful creations were entered. We would like to show all of them to you. I would love to invite the judges to announce this year's contest winners. Do we have Julia?
Right. Yes. First of all, I'd like to give two honorable mentions for amazing creations that didn't make the top three. And first of all, that would be Annabelle Folsom with her amazing hair sculpture. We didn't feel like she could win best hat, but oh my goodness, that hair was absolutely amazing. I think you should be able to see it. Oh,
yeah.
Absolutely amazing. Is Annabelle here? Yeah. Hi, Annabelle. Good job, if you are here. And then we also wanted to give a honorable mention to Patayano for her amazing crescent moon. Do you have a photograph of the crescent moon? Isn't this amazing? Can't imagine how she can see, but I'm sure it would have been really glamorous in real life. I would have loved to see this at the ball. And then let me move on to our third place winner, which is Deborah Scotti with this amazing headpiece with a with moons and the planets and everything. So fantastic. Really good job, Deborah. Cheers.
And I have the honor of announcing second place, and that goes to Francesca Murphy. Francesca, are you there? No, I don't know. I'm really bad at the Zoom thing, so sorry about that. But Francesca Murphy, she did this incredible swan piece, absolutely gorgeous. I'm obsessed with it, love it. So second prize goes to Francesca. Congratulations.
So it is my honor to announce that the number one prize goes to Wanda Chambers with her halo hat. All the different ecstasies and different dimensions that she's given us, it's very celestial and beautiful.
Thank you. So congratulations to all. Thank you, everybody, for participating. We loved seeing all the contributions this year, and we once again hope you can wear them in person next year. Would the winners like to say something?
Wanda Chambers, once upon a hat, member of the Milliners Guild. And when you said celestial, I said heaven, and it was a halo. And I am so thankful. I wish I could come. I love the Bonnet Bash. And I just want to thank everybody. And my husband thanks you too.
So we will actually move on to the social portion of the evening, where everybody has the opportunity to show off their headdresses and can say something in a little bit. I did not want to miss the portion of the Bonnet Bash that is usually the one of the best liked and most interactive. As I said, you can come naked, we will give you a hat. So at each Bonnet Bash, there have been hat-making stations with instructions, and we usually would run out of material within 20 minutes of the evening. So as we can't do that tonight, we would like to share some educational hat-making, at least for you, courtesy of our wonderful Sarah Sokol.
I get to be a sculptor and just make art, and people wear it on their heads. And it's just like the craziest thing that that's a job.
This is Sarah Sokol. You may not recognize the face under this hat, but scroll through your Instagram feed or flip through the pages of a fashion magazine, and you'll find Sokol's designs on the heads of your favorite celebs. Cardi B, Emilia Clarke, and WWE star Lacey Evans, to name a few. But it wasn't until the 2019 Met Gala that Sokol floored the world with her iconic design composed of four stacked hats worn by the artist and actress Janelle Monáe.
It was just so surreal, crazy. You know, to be a small designer on the red carpet is insane. And it was just straight up like, you know, dream come true, a dream I didn't even know was obtainable.
Paired with a surrealist blinking eye dress by Christian Siriano, Sokol's four-tiered hat propelled Monáe onto several best dress lists after the camp-filled night. We got a peek inside Sokol's studio to learn specifically how she made her iconic Met Gala hat for Janelle Monáe.
Welcome to my studio.
Sokol owns and operates Sarah Sokol Millinery Incorporated, right from our home studio in Brooklyn, where she makes and sells custom pieces ranging from $400 to $3,500. Depending on the piece and the client's wishes, each new hat takes Sokol anywhere from 2 hours to 2 days to finish. She made Monáe's hat in under 40 hours.
So this is part of the hat that I made for Janelle Monáe for the Met Gala. She had a stacked four of these. So I made four different ones of these. It really looked like four separate hats, like all stacked together.
Sokol uses a variety of materials like mylars, metals, plexiglass, and thermoplastics to make her designs come to life. To create Monáe's iconic look, Sokol chose to use velour felt.
we went velour felt for Janelle and the Mecca. Come on.
Once the material is chosen, the first step is to steam the felt body. The steam allows the felt to become malleable so that Sokol can stretch it out over a wooden block that she specifically created to fit Monet's head.
Trying to do different like heights and everything, there was a really fine line between couture and like cartoon and gimmicky. With crowns, you really need like every single different size. So like 21 inches, 21 and a half, 22, 22 and a half. So, you know, to go up only like a quarter inch to do something like this was really the way to go.
The steaming and stretching process may need to be repeated a few times to give the felt body the biggest stretch possible.
Oh, look at that. Oh, I love it.
Once the body is blocked nice and tight over the crown, an elastic is pulled down over to secure the felt in place.
So I'll put the elastic on, and then wherever it's still buckling, I'm just gonna put a little more steam and keep pulling it down that way.
Next, blocking pins are added to maintain the body's shape. Now it's time to pull out the brim, steaming one section at a time and pinning it down. The key is to get the brim as wide as possible. Using a damp cloth to protect the felt, the brim is then pressed with an iron to flatten it out. The hat is then dried. Size the hat by measuring the length of the brim.
And then this one is only a 6-foot circumference, but the side pieces also need to be wired and stitched and then attached to it. So you're essentially sewing that circumference like 3 times. I know.
The hat is then cut to perfection. The final brim is lined with a steel wire to secure and flatten out the hat. In Monet's case, Sokol made a 2-inch strip of ribbon out of the white fabric that was used for her dress.
I felt very appreciated and recognized by Janelle. And, you know, when she had posted and like mentioned me about it and posted the time-lapse video, to me that's like the highest form of compliment when an artist recognizes other people's craftsmanship and artistry. I felt really part of the team. And to feel that way when you're working with people like Christian Siriano and you're on a red carpet with like the biggest and best designers out there, to feel appreciated as like a small Brooklyn milliner and to be a young one is just the most important thing to keeping this trade alive.
Isn't that amazing? Sarah, you're amazing. Thank you so much for sharing that with everyone and for sharing your journey with us. I remember the early days at the Bonnet Bash. So we feel very moved that you kind of came back home. Thank you so much. So I want to see everyone else now. Who is wearing a hat?
I didn't go with the theme, but in my theme in my life all around me is flowers and blooming and opening and transformation. So I'm wearing one of my, I make hats, I make fascinators actually, and I'm very proud to be here and thank you very much. I wanted to have a taste of what's going on and it's just wonderful. I'm really inspired. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mary Lynn Bergman-Rollis, and I live in Newport Beach, California. This is, the solar system. The interesting thing about this hat is that I happen to sit on the board of our local community college, and after 10 years, we realized a dream and built and opened a planetarium on the college campus. And some of the elements of this hat are actually pieces of construction craft that I found on the floor when I was going through the planetarium. So it's kind of a combo of elements, an homage to the planetarium.
Oh, I'm so thrilled to be here. I was eighth place winner. Well, out of the 7 sins, I was given a special prize for my confessional. So I came sin-related last year, well, the year before. And I can't thank Sarah Soka and Julia Knox enough. I am so honored that the two of you that are experienced in millinery picked me for an eighth prize. Thank you. I am. So I'm the baby and I'm just an experimental milliner. So I love the challenge. So bring it on.
I would be the Imelda Marcos of hats if I could. I wish I just had enough space. And this is just a little shy thing, but I love hats. Love them, love them, love them.
My name is Marina McCluskey. I cannot thank the National Arts Club and Nina and all of the organizers for this wonderful opportunity to have so much joy and to have so much fun. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Jasmine. I'm in Helsinki right now, and I'm so happy that I get the chance to attend this Bonnet Bash. It's the most inspiring thing. It's amazing. I'm just so delighted to see this. So thank you so much.
Hi, good to see everybody. I did not make my hat, but I thought it was appropriate for tonight. I'm enjoying everybody's work and really great work, you guys.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jennifer, a small-time designer of costumes for Costumegasm, and I dabble in headpieces, but this one was my first headpiece using the inside of a construction helmet, which you can see here, and it has, you know, a little light up in there. But I can thank Costume Jim for that piece of information. So I started off with a little pre-made, and then I went wild with wire and feathers. So I'm really grateful to see, like, the beautiful videos and all the beautiful winners, and this is a very inspiring, as always, event, even virtually. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Marilyn Wolf. This is actually my second hat ever I've made, and that was just in the past 2 weeks. And I was just so amazed to find this event. It's just, the talent is amazing. Thank you.
Oh, hello, everyone. I'm having so much fun. I didn't have a hat, but I said, oh, I'm going to create my own bonnet. So, you know, I'm trying. And I think next year I'm going to really create one. Thank you, everyone.
So this is my first Bonnet Bash, and I really didn't know what to expect. And it's like far exceeds anything that I imagined. It's really wonderful. I didn't expect so much talent. And anyway, I'm great. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you so much. And I'll look forward to next year's.
Hello, it's me again. Actually, it's not me. I just wanted to present the lovely headpiece, Deborah.
Hello, thank you everybody, and thank you for the prize to the judges. I really appreciate the acknowledgement, and to the National Arts Club, thank you for providing the space for all of us to come together and do such a, you know, an amazing event every year. And you know, have a good night, everybody. Thank you for coming.
As you can see, I was not totally alone, but most important, I was with all of you around the country and even around the world. Thank you, everybody, for sharing your wonderful creativity. Thank you, everybody, for attending. I hope it got you gave you an impression of what's happening here, and at least a little hour of celebrating creativity. I would like to thank again the National Arts Lab, but in particular, Mitch Case, who without whom tonight would not have happened, and again the support of the Fashion Committee and everybody else at the National Arts Club. I hope to see you all again in person next year, hopefully sooner. The National Arts Club continues to have online programming for all the arts. Check out the National Arts Club website and also the YouTube channel. So there's something for everybody. So thank you, my wonderful judges. Thank you, Verity, Julia, and Sarah, for participating. This really made my evening. So have a great night.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.